In today's talk, I am going to share with you three techniques with the help of which you would be able to sharpen your problem-solving skills. Is what I call as BDFRP approach. He solved the problem in an unconventional manner. He developed his own shortcuts. He developed his own tips. जान लगा दूंगा पर सोल्यूशन नहीं देखूंगा और यही बात मैं आपसे कहना चाहता हूँ कि या तो जान लगा दीजिए या फिर अपने गोल्स और ड्रीम को जाने दीजिए. Hello everybody, the topic of today's talk, how to sharpen problem solving skills, is very interesting and important for all the aspirants, or in other words, how to 10x your problem solving speed. In competitive examinations, it is not important that whether you know a question or not. It is not important that whether you can solve a question or not, but what is important is that can you solve the question in shortest possible time or not? Or in other words, can you solve the question faster than others or not? And for you to solve questions in the shortest possible time, what is extremely important is that how do you approach or how do you attack a question or what comes to your mind when you see the question. And so the key issue involved so as to attack the question in the right way or how to approach the question in the right way is about problem solving. So let's come to the topic of today's discussion, how to sharpen your problem solving skills. My name is Avinash Agarwal and I'm your success guide in the journey of cracking exams, scoring more marks and achieving your goals. In today's talk, I am going to share with you three techniques with the help of which you would be able to sharpen your problem-solving skills. So the technique number one, get deep understanding of the basic concepts. Now this is the area wherein most of the students go wrong. What they do is that they skip, whenever they are learning anything new, they skip the fundamentals and directly move on to the problem-solving. And this is not the right approach. With half-baked knowledge, you will start facing problems sooner or later. The right approach to develop deep understanding of the fundamentals is what I call as BDFRP approach. I will explain you this approach, and if you apply this approach in your learning, your problem solving skills will get strengthened like anything. So here B stands for the first alphabet B, and understanding the background of the concept. What it means is that whenever you are learning anything new, understand the background of the concept. What is the concept all about? Why was it required? What is the significance? What is the exceptions? Why does where is the need? What was the need for this concept? So what I'm trying to say is that before directly moving on to the questions or to the formula, it is extremely important to understand the background of the concept, and that is what B stands for. The second is D, that is the steps of derivation. Here also what most of the students do is that they directly skip the steps of the derivation, move on to the formula, and then move on to the problem solving skills. Always remember, the steps of derivation are extremely helpful. Apart from developing a strong conceptual framework, they also help you in problem solving skills. So I would advise and highly recommend all the students to follow all the steps of derivation without missing even a single step. So that is, first was B, second was D, and then we come to the third step, which is the formula. After solving the steps of derivation, you reach to the formula. So whenever you reach the formula of the concept, try to understand the formula from the perspective of the what was the background of the concept and what were the steps of the derivation. What I'm trying to say is that just visualize the formula in your eyes and go move backwards and try to understand how is the formula, how is the representation of the formula linked to the steps of derivation and the steps and the background of the concept. So that is the third thing, which is the F, which is the formula. And after you reach the formula, the fourth step or the fourth thing which comes into question is reproducing the concept in your own words. Whenever you have when you have understood the background of the concept, when you have solved the steps of derivation, you have understood the formula, the next step you should try to reproduce the entire concept in your own words. This would help you in clearing your doubts and strengthening the overall understanding of the concept. Once you have reproduced the concept in your own words, then comes the last step, which is problem solving. So solve as many questions as possible, but always remember that whenever you face problems, whenever you face any hurdle in problem solving, or whenever you are not able to solve any question, you have to again go back to the first step, which was the background. So I shared with you a technique which is called as BDRF technique. B stands for understanding the background of the concept, D stands for understanding the derivation of the concepts, F stands for formula, R stands for reproducing the concept, and the last step was problem solving. And I shared that if you face problem in problem solving, then again you have to go back to the first step, which is understanding the background of the concept. Believe me, my friends, this is the technique which I've learned from a topper, and if you implement this technique in your preparation, even for a month or two, you will yourself start seeing the result, and it will take your overall understanding. Because remember, success in JEE or success in NEET is not about running fast, it is about running in the right direction. It is only and only about how strong your fundamental or how strong your concepts are. So that was the step number one. Now the technique two, which I want to share with you, is visualization of the problem. Now visualization is a skill which is extremely important whenever you're solving any kind of problems, be it a problem of physics or be it a problem of mathematics. In visualization, what we do is that we read the question and we convert the question in the form of a diagram and we try to visualize it. I will share with you a very interesting story. As all of you know that I have written a book which is called Toppers. When I was writing this book, I was trying to recollect all the experiences of my childhood. One interesting incident came to my mind which I am going to share with you. I think it was class 5th or 6th. It was a maths class. Kaushik sir was taking the maths class. And Kaushik sir that day gave us a question, write down the sum of the first 100 digits. What is the sum of the first 100 digits? By that, however, there is a direct formula, but n bracket n plus 1 by 2. But by that time, we were not taught that formula. So the only way to find out the result, or the only way to find out the sum of the first 100 digits, everybody thought was to write 1, 200 and then to draw two lines and sum it up. You know, while everybody was trying to do this, there was a lot of commotion in the class. Desk ऊपर नीचे हो रहे थे, कोई pencil को sharpen कर रहा था, कोई कह रहा था copy दे, कोई कह रहा था rubber दे, कोई कह रहा था eraser थे. Everybody was in a hurry because everybody wanted to be the first one to answer the question. By the time I could reach, I had started writing. और इससे पहले कि मैं 8 या 9 या 10 तक 8, 9 या 10 तक लिख पाता, मेरे बराबर में जो student बैठा था सुरेंद्र कुमार जैन, he raised his hand and he said, sir, the answer is 5050. Now the moment he said the answer is 5050, Kaushik sir ke haath se mano chalk gir gayi. He was surprised, he was shocked, he was astonished. He said the answer is correct, but then he asked Surendra, did you know the question before or have you solved it or did you know the answer before? Surendra said, sir, no, I did not know the question before. I was hearing it for the first time. But unfortunately, sir, I did not bring my pencil box today, so I did not have anything to write about. So I thought that instead of solving it by hand, I visualized 1 to 100 in front of my mind. He said, I visualized 1 to 100 in front of my mind और 100 को उठा के मैंने साइड में रख दिया, बच गए 1 से लेकर 99. एक डिजिट पहले से लिया, एक डिजिट लास्ट से लिया, दोनों को सम अप कर दिया. 1 plus 99 100 हो गया, 2 plus 98 100 हो गया, 3 plus 97 100 हो गया, 49 plus 51 100 हो गया. इस तरीके से 49 पेयर्स हो गए 100 के, दैट मेक्स इट 4900. नीचे 50 बच गया था, 4950. 100 को उठा के उधर से रखा था, इसको मिला के हमने जोड़ दिया 5050. That is thinking out of the box. That is what JEE and NEET is looking about. As I said, that it is not about running fast, it is about running in the right direction. Success in JEE or success in NEET is about ability to think both critically and creatively in front of new situation. And that is what Surendra Kumar Jain demonstrated that day. With the help of visualization, he solved the problem in an unconventional manner. He developed his own shortcuts, he developed his own tips. That friend of mine, couple of years later, scored a double digit rank in IIT JEE. So coming back to, I was discussing about what visualization, and as I shared with you, visualization is a technique in which we try to convert the question in the form of a diagram. So what are the basic steps you follow? You first of all try to convert the question in the form of a diagram, then check whether the diagram is representing the question or not. Does the diagram make sense? Can you understand the question with the help of this diagram? Is the diagram representing whatever was given in the question? If you can understand the question with the help of the diagram, that means you have correctly represented the question in the form of a diagram. Then the next step is that you look for what is being asked in the question with the help of the diagram, or you look for an answer with the help of this diagram. Visualization, as I said, is an extremely important skill, especially in physics and maths. So I've discussed with you two techniques. First was get deep understanding of the conceptual framework, or get deep understanding of the basic concepts. And the second skill was visualization of the problem. The third tip or the third technique is continuous interplay between theory and problem solving. The mistake which most of the students do is that while they're preparing, like for example, if this is the theoretical part or the conceptual part, and this is the problem solving part. So they understand the theory, they read the theory, then they move on to the problem solving. But when they are moving on to the problem solving, and whenever they get stuck, they don't come back to the theory. So these are two distant poles apart. Whereas what I'm trying to say is that whenever you want to sharpen your problem solving skills, there should be continuous interplay between theory and problem solving. What I truly mean to say is that whenever you get stuck in any question, any problem, the only way is to go backward and look for the fundamental, or look for the theoretical part and try to find a solution through that. I will share with you a very interesting incident. This was around 10 to 12 years back. I was interviewing a student who had topped JEE that year. He lived in a small village near Jaipur, and you know, when I spoke to him, I was very excited, very enthusiastic and very anxious to know his secrets. I immediately started my interview with him. So what is the secret of success? And, you know, that boy took me to study room, and in front of his study table there was a big white chart, and on the top of, in the bottom of the white chart there was a secret written, and he said, this is my secret of success. Would you like to know what was written in the bottom of the white chart? It was written, come what may, I will not see the solution. He said, Jaan laga dunga, par solution nahi dekhunga. That is what he literally said. And you know, whenever I recollect what he said and the passion with which he said, my goosebumps khade ho jate hain tarike se. Aaj bhi wo baat se ek tarike se rongte se khade ho jate hain. Uska josh, uska confidence dekh ke. He said, Jaan laga dunga, par solution nahi dekhunga. Aur yahi baat main aapse kehna chahta hoon ki ya to jaan laga dijiye ya fir apne goals aur dream ko जाने दीजिए, क्योंकि दोनों चीज़ें एक साथ नहीं हो सकती. बिना जान लगाए गोल्स और ड्रीम्स नहीं मिलेंगी. देन आई आस्क्ड हिम व्हेन दैट स्टूडेंट सेड ओके, आई सेड ओके यू वुड नॉट सी द सॉल्यूशन, बट व्हाट इज दैट यू डू इफ यू गेट स्टक इन ए प्रॉब्लम. सो ही आई विल एक्सप्लेन टू यू व्हाट इज दैट ही सेड दैट व्हेनेवर ही सॉल्विंग ए क्वेश्चन, इफ ही गेट स्टक इन ए प्रॉब्लम, ही लीव्स द क्वेश्चन, ही वुड कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन आफ्टर वन और टू आवर्स. इफ ही इज एबल टू सॉल्व इट, इट इज वेल एंड गुड. इफ ही इज नॉट एबल टू सॉल्व इट, ही विल स्किप द क्वेश्चन एंड ही विल कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन आफ्टर टू और थ्री डेज. पर दो तीन दिन के बाद जब वो उस क्वेश्चन के बारे में आएगा, तो उस क्वेश्चन को पहले किस तरीके से अटेम्प्ट किया था उसको देखने की बात तो दूर ही है, उसके बारे में सोचना भी नहीं है. कहने का मतलब है, बिल्कुल फ्रेश पर्सपेक्टिव से, बिल्कुल फ्रेश माइंड से, एक नए नजरिए से उस क्वेश्चन को देखना चाहते हैं. उस क्वेश्चन को एक नए नजरिए से, नई दिशा में अटैक करना है. और तो पुराना जहां पे हमने देखा था या किया था उसको हम देखेंगे भी नहीं. एक फ्रेश थॉट से उसको अप्रोच किया. अगर वो क्वेश्चन हो जाता है तो ठीक है, अगर नहीं होता है देन ही सेड दैट ही वुड आइडेंटिफाई व्हाट इज द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट इन्वॉल्वड इन दैट क्वेश्चन. फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ द क्वेश्चन इज बेस्ड ऑन न्यूटन्स फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन, ही सेड दैट ही वुड ओपन हिज फंडामेंटल बुक, दैट चैप्टर, दैट पेज वेयर इन न्यूटन्स फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन इज बीइंग डिस्कस्ड. He said that the question is there in the back of your mind. Question आपके दिमाग में इधर से उधर बहुत तेजी से घूम रहा है. आपकी माइंड, आपकी बॉडी डेस्परेटली कोशिश कर रही है कि उस क्वेश्चन का सोल्यूशन ढूंढे. आप उस चैप्टर के उस पेज को जहाँ पे उस क्वेश्चन का कंसेप्चुअल फ्रेमवर्क डिस्कस्ड है धीरे धीरे पढ़ रहे हैं. नॉर्मली जिस तेजी से फिजिक्स पढ़ते हैं उससे आधी या चौथाई तेजी से धीरे धीरे पढ़ रहे हैं. इंटरनेशनल रिसर्च कहती है अगर आप किसी फोकस्ड क्वेश्चन के साथ अगर थ्योरी को पेनिट्रेट करते हैं तो देर आर 70% चांसेस दैट यू वुड बी एबल टू फाइंड अ सॉल्यूशन टू दैट क्वेश्चन. एंड इफ यू आर एबल टू फाइंड अ सॉल्यूशन टू दैट क्वेश्चन, रिमेंबर माय फ्रेंड्स, द गेम इज वन, द बैटल इज वन, यू हैव वन. नो, देर इज नो फोर्स विच कैन स्टॉप यू फ्रॉम सक्सीडिंग, वेदर इट इज जेई और वेदर इट इज नीट और एनी अदर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जामिनेशन इन द वर्ल्ड. यू हैव टेकन द फर्स्ट स्टेप टूवर्ड्स शार्पनिंग योर प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग स्किल्स. यू हैव टेकन योर फर्स्ट स्टेप टूवर्ड्स डेवलपिंग योर ओन शॉर्टकट्स एंड ट्रिक्स. But here also there is a word of caution. This is a very painful, this is a very slow, this is a very frustrating process. This will give you a lot of tension because there would be times wherein you will get stuck in a question for half an hour, 45 minutes, for 1 hour and 2 minutes. But don't worry, my friends, that time is not getting wasted. That time is getting invested. Each and every question with which you are struggling will take your problem solving to the next level. So do not see the solutions. You should only and only refer the solutions when you have given the best. So I've discussed with you three broad frameworks or three broad tips with the help of which you can sharpen your problem solving skills, or with the help of which you can 10x your problem solving skills. The first tip was develop deep understanding of the concepts with the help of BDFRP framework. The second was visualization, the technique of visualization. And the third tip or the third technique was continuous interplay between theory and problem solving. So remember, my friends, all of you have promised me that you will not see the solution till the time you have given your best. In the end, I would like to tell you about my book. I have recently written a book which is called Topper Study Hack. The book is based upon the success story of more than 100 NEET and JEE toppers whom I have interviewed in the last 15 years. The book has got a lot of tips and techniques which have the capability, which have the power to take your preparation to a different level altogether. The book talks about all aspects of preparation. It has a lot of case studies, a lot of interesting stories, a lot of interesting experiences of the toppers, like revision kaise karna hai, question paper ko attempt kaise karna hai, strategy kaise banani hai, distraction se kaise dur hona hai, focus kaise develop karna hai, subject ke andar interest kaise karna hai, raat ko padhna hai ya din mein padhna hai, एक सब्जेक्ट पढ़ने या दो सब्जेक्ट पढ़ने, फिजिक्स को कैसे पढ़ना है, केमिस्ट्री को कैसे पढ़ना है, प्लानिंग कैसे बननी है. बिलीव मी माय फ्रेंड्स, ईच एंड एवरी क्वेश्चन विच यू हैव इन योर माइंड, दिस बुक हैज गॉट एन आंसर टू दैट क्वेश्चन. सो आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू गेट अ कॉपी ऑफ द बुक. द बुक इज अवेलेबल बोथ एट अमेजन एंड फ्लिपकार्ट. थैंक यू, बाय बाय एंड गॉड ब्लेस यू.